नमस्ते स्वाति, नमस्ते ममता मैम। माय नेम इज़ साइरा साळुंखे एंड टुडे आई विल बी प्रेजेंटिंग ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ कार्बन फाइबर्स। टू बिगिन विद द मॉर्फोलॉजी ऑफ द कार्बन फाइबर, ऑन द लेफ्ट वी कैन सी दैट द कार्बन फाइबर्स आर फ्यू 10 नैनोमीटर्स टू फ्यू माइक्रोमीटर्स थिक। अ कंपेरिजन विद ह्यूमन हेयर इज शोन इन द लेफ्ट डायग्राम। ऑन द राइट इज द क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ द कार्बन फाइबर इन विच द अमाउंट ऑफ क्रिस्टलिनिटी, द अमॉर्फस रीजन्स एंड द मिक्स रीजन्स आर वेरी वेल कंट्रोल्ड बाई द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेस दैट वी चूज। द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेस दैट आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग टूडे इज द इलेक्ट्रोस्पिनिंग। इन इलेक्ट्रोस्पिनिंग देर आर थ्री मेन कंपोनेंट्स, दैट इज द सिरिंज पंप, द स्पिनरेट एंड द मेटल कलेक्टर। द सिरिंज पंप विल लोड द पॉलीमर सोल्यूशन इन टू द स्पिनरेट। अ पेंडल ड्रॉप विल बी क्रिएटेड बाई द पंप। When we give a positive bias to the spinrad and a negative bias to the metal collector, then the metal collector will attract the pendant drop and a Taylor cone will be generated through which a jet will be formed and that will be collected on the fiber mat. Initially the jet is stable and then it becomes unstable because of the change in the viscoelastic property. When the phase transition from the semi solid to a solid phase occurs. The factors that affect the type of mat we'll be getting is the concentration of the solution, viscosity, electric conductivity, surface tension and dielectric properties, whereas the voltage that we apply, the fluid flow rate and the spin rate to metal collector distance also affects the fiber mat quality. Also the ambience, humidity and temperature also has effect on the fiber mat. There are different types of feed. On the left is the multi-syringe feed, in which we use it to scale up the production, whereas on the right we have the coaxial type of feed, in which we use this type of feed to produce a hollow carbon fibers. There are basically four types of collectors: the plate collector, disc collector, drum collector and a mantle collector. We get almost similar plate similar type of fiber mat from the plate collector and the drum collector. The only difference is that the drum collector is having a continuous mat. In the disc type of collector, we get a very similar orientation or the parallel orientation of these fibers. On the left is a image of a special type of carbon mat produced by the aluminium mesh. This generates a diamond-shaped carbon fiber mat. To explain the further process after the electrospinning, I have taken this experiment from a paper. In which the polyacrylonitrile PAN, polyvinyl pyrrolidone PVP and dimethyl formamide DMF are used. The PAN is the precursor from which the carbon fiber will be generated. PVP is used to generate the pores in the carbon fiber, and DMF is the solvent in which the PAN and the PVP will be dissolved. The concentration of PAN and DMF is constant throughout at 0.8 grams and 9 milliliters respectively, but the concentration of PVP is increased from 0.2 to 1 grams. So the four samples after the electrospun is shown in this SEM image. There is hardly any difference when it comes to surface morphology in this. We have applied the 10 kilovolt bias to the spin rate and the metal collector. The distance between the spindle and collector is around 10 to 15 centimeters. After the electrospin fiber is then taken to a second stage, wherein it is dried vacuum to remove all the solvent DMF, and then it is treated at 100 degrees Celsius to remove the remaining PVP. Now this leads to the increase in surface area and the pore sizes. It is very evident from this image on the left side. The surface morphology shows that the surface area and the pores have increased. On the right is the cross-sectional morphologies of the same samples after the treatment has been done at the stage 2. In stage 3, we incorporate the carbonization process, in which all the elements other than that of carbon are removed. Now this will increase the surface area, pore size and its volume drastically. We heat the sample at 1000 degrees Celsius at a rate of 5 degrees Celsius per minute at N2 environment, and this is done in a cylindrical electric furnace. Characterization of the electrospun fibers are tabulated in this table. We can see that the C4 sample after the carbonization has increased more than that of the C1 sample. This is because of the concentration of PVP in these samples. So from this we get to know that the concentration of PVP, we can control the surface area, the pore volume and the pore size. Through characterization techniques such as XRD, we find and peak at the 002 and 101 plane. This indicates that the sample had graphite as well as turbostatic graphite structures in it. Also, through Raman spectroscopy, we get to know that the crystal size of these graphites are somewhere around 4.7 to 5.6 nanometers, and the mole fraction of these graphites are from 0.52 to 0.56 respectively. Now this shows that we are having a high content of crystal structures in it, and this will increase the electrical conductivity. This brings to us the application of such type of carbon materials is the ELDC supercapacitor electrodes. In this, the coaxial type of feed was used to generate a very hollow carbon fibers, and by this we get a capacitance of around 164.2 farads per gram, and the retention of this capacitance was around 68.6% at 30 amperes per gram. Thank you. That's it from my side. Jai Hind.